What's up, guys? Yeah, it has been a while since I uploaded a tutorial, and today I've decided to bring you a tutorial on how I usually make my mashups, the 1 minute mashups that I've been uploading for the past 2 months. So I just want to show you a glimpse of what I usually do, and I hope on your side you can improve on something or learn something new. Even before we dive in, I just want to say thank you for the guys who have been commenting, leaving a like, subscribing for the new individuals, and some in other individuals DMing me on IG to say thank you for the tutorials. I really appreciate it. And last but not least, I'm thanking the guys who have been supporting the channel by purchasing the merchandise that I've been selling through Telegram. I really appreciate it. If you purchased it, from the bottom of our hearts, we really appreciate it. Yeah, because the cash usually make a big change on this side and keep on motivating us to keep on going, not as DigiSub but as Ground Zero DJs. I never walk alone. It is better to walk with a team. Yeah, so we are thankful. So today, let me take care of this business. And even before we go far, I go by the name Sub the King, aka Mr. Mufasa. So let us dive in. So here we are in Serato DJ Pro. Yeah, nothing spectacular about it apart from the white theme. So I've already selected my track over here. I'm pretty sure you guys know it. I'll just give you a glimpse of it.
Lil Nico. Here I go.
Up to there, I'm pretty sure if you're a hip hop head, you've come across this song. So let us dive into Sony Acid. And guys, don't forget that we are Ground Zero DJs. So here we are in Sony Acid. I've already set up the song. The song is at a BPM of 70, so I've pitched it up a little to be 73. So the speed to add more life and energy onto it. So here it is. Yeah, so whenever I usually make the mashups, I usually dive in freestyle. So over here, I will try to turn my freestyle into a lesson. Yeah, so bear with me because there'll be a couple of experimentation here and there. Yeah, so I've already set up the track. The song is at 0.0. So what I'll do next, I'll just add like other two audio tracks. I press Control Q on my keyboard, the shortcut. Yeah, make them 0.0. Then for this one, I'll make it a flange / wah. Then make it the preset, make it to a wah one, just like that. And then this one, I'll turn it to a reverb, just like that. And whenever I add my reverb, I usually don't tweak anything. I just leave it the way it is on its default parameters. Yeah, so let us dive in. I'll zoom in. So I'll just play it, and then I'll start marking where I can drop the downbeat. Yeah, they are, so as you can see, they are not on point, but I know this is the part that I wanted, this one and this one. Yeah, so another thing you'll just slice this section and this section and this section. So then you play it again. Yeah, just like that. So what I would love to do, I'll just take this section where this young individual says, I'm the man. Yeah, so I'll slice it. And since over here, this is a snare. This is a snare too. So I'll slice it too. So I'll delete this and this. So I'll take this and paste it at the bottom. Yeah, just like that. So when I play it, here I go, I'm the man. then take this and lay it over there. So I'll play it from here. So I'll just do a scratch, and don't forget that this is a hip-hop song, a hip-hop track. So you can try experiment your 32 boxes, and at the same time you can experiment your 16 boxes and combine them. It will sound great. So we zoom in to our 16 boxes. Slice, copy. Just like that. Yeah, so I'll reverse this one. And then make this one to be longer. Just like that. Drag this over here. Yeah, just like that. Reverse it, pitch it like positive 2 or 3. It depends with what you want. Make this one over here, you're leaving 3 boxes. So when you play it, this is how it will sound like. Just like that. So another thing you can do, you can slice over here and over here, and take this one at the bottom, lay it at the bottom. Then you do a scratch over here. Just make sure you're still following the rule of jumping 3 boxes. Yeah, so just like that. Just like that. Then you give it a try. So what you can do over here, you can slice this and delete the rest. Then drag and on the reverb. Now we're on the reverb audio track. No, it's too far. And then you can this section. Yeah. You can make it now, fade it. Sixteen boxes, you can drag this and lay it over here. Just like that, and then you give it a here. So another thing that you can do, you can slice over here. Then take this section, remove this section and lay it at the bottom. Then this, open another audio track and lay it over here and make this audio track express delay. Express delay, where is it? My friend Vijay Hancho usually use the simple delay, and it usually works the same. So on your side, you can tweak it to have the same results. So just reduce this a little and give it a year. Yeah, just like that. So over here, what you can do, you can slice this section, cut it and paste it at the bottom. Then we want to scratch this snare. Yes. So zoom in, 16 boxes, so that you can grab the scratch. Sorry. Slice, copy it. Then when you paste it, since over here there is a gap, so we don't want the gap. You'll push it in forward a little with the number pad on the right side if you have a full keyboard. Yes, so that we can get the scratch to its fullest. Just like that. So you start with your 16 boxes. As you keep on going, you make them 32. And then over here, I'll just use three of them, I believe. I usually prefer starting with three. You chain positive two. And then you can make this one longer. On your 32. And try to chain this one. Positive three. It's not bad. And then you give it a here. Yeah, so what you can do, delete this one, then jump 5 boxes. Now you have already jumped 3, 4, 5. Pitch this one 1, 2, 3. Just like that. And then you can take this one and bring it over here. Positive 3, positive 3, positive 3, positive 3. Then you give it a here. So let us listen to it like from here. So what you can do over here, you can slice. Then you paste it at the bottom. Ah, sorry. Copy, then paste this one at the bottom. Then zoom in. So another thing that I would want to do, I would want to make another audio track for reverb. Let me tell you why and show you why. So reverb. Yeah, just like that. So when I'm like where this young fellow says, I'm the man. So I wouldn't want him to say I'm the man till the end. So I would want him to let me lay this on, yeah, over here, to say it like as it keeps on going. Not we can do it like this, I'm the man. But I don't want that. We've already done it over here, so we can try and place it over here. Yeah, it's like a flip double, but or a bit grid, but on a reverb. And then you kill the volume, place this in the middle, copy it, and place it at the top, just like that. And then you give it a here and see and hear how it sounds like. And then you can come over here. Yeah, so what you can do, you can take this and lay it over here. Or you can do a scratch, so let us just copy this to save time. Right now we are on our 16, so I'll just drag this and lay it over here. And then give it a here. Then what we'll do is just slice, take this one and lay it on the express delay. So, and drag this all. Just like that. And reverse it. So when you listen to it from here. Just like that. So another thing, now you might be wondering why I haven't had added the effects. So I can say I had even forgotten that I should be adding effects, because that's the problem that I usually have. Most of the time I end up making a mashup and forgetting to add effects, so I start to force them inside the project and it usually sounds totally off. So bear with me. So we'll just carry on without the effects and we can try to add the effects later on. So right now we are here, so we can try like other other ideas. So like flick doubled. Step time. So up to there we are good. So I'll open another audio track and I won't add anything. So I'll take it at the top. So I'll just copy this and paste it at the bottom. So I'll just slice it as a zigzag. Yeah, and then I'll copy this. Yeah, just like that. So when I play it, it will be the normal one. Yeah, so I wouldn't want to play the normal one. We've done it a million of times, I believe. So I'll just copy all of this that after the first one. Then I'll drag it and lay it over here. I'll leave this one and do the same on this one. Leave this one. Just like that. Yeah, just like that. And then you can come. So what you can do, you can just come, copy, paste, then that two boxes. Yeah, just like that. Then you play it. Yeah. So another thing that you can do, you can drag this and make it full and cut it and paste it on the wow. Then you start scratching the snare. Yeah. You can try different variations and see what you'll come up with. Yeah. And then what you can do, you can take this and lay it on the express delay. 16 boxes, slice, copy. Paste it, and then give it a here. Yeah, just like that. And then we can take this and lay it on the reverb. Just like that. Yeah, so over here, we can allow it to play. Then over here, you can take this, open another audio track, bring in the bottom, plugin chooser, this is the effect, it is, hoping to it won't crash my Sony Acid, hoping, yeah, it has accepted. So over here, if you don't know what I'm doing, you can check out the previous tutorials on how to do a break effect. So just like that. Yeah, just like that. And then you can come and grab this one. Copy it. Paste it at the bottom. So you can kill the volume as you keep on moving. Just like that. So when we play it, yeah. can make a scratch over here. Copy, Control Z. Reverse this 1, 2, and make them small, as well as this one over here. Reverse, makes them small, then you give it a here. Yeah, so let us listen to it from the top. So it's getting, I can say we are giving it life as we carry on. So delete this one, we can take this and lay it at the bottom, make it -1, -2, then we hit listen, then you can try, you can grab like this section over here, 16 boxes. Yeah, now since before he had tried, we lay this in the middle, bring this one and make this one smaller, then you give it a here, you see how it will sound like. Yeah, so we can cut this one and lay it on the reverb, I believe. Don't know, maybe this is the reverb. Yeah, then we rub it. Yeah, we drag and lay it over here. Yeah, just like that. You can come and grab this scratch over here. Yeah, so you can come over here, cut this, and lay it at the bottom. So we'll just press V to save on time. Yeah, so then we take there's a section. Let me play this. Yeah, just like that. And then I'll take this. Sorry. Cut it and lay it on the. On the wire. Yeah. Yeah. Now, so that for this snare to work, you have to like. Let me bring this one over up to here. This one up to here, so you drag and see where the snare is at. Yeah, here's the snare, so you just mark it, then slice and delete the rest. So for the snare to work, it must be here. Yeah. So zoom in. 16 boxes. Just like that. Not yet. You can take this slice and lay it at the maybe this. No. Then you can take and lay it over here. Oh, not. Then you scratch this. Yeah, it usually takes a lot of time, but when you're slow and precise, in the end you'll have the best results of your life. So just make it this to be a 32 boxes scratch. Yeah, so let us play it from the top. Let me see how far we've gone. Yeah, 26 minutes. So we got four minutes to wrap it up. So I'll just play it. So let me pause the video, add the effects, and then we wrap it up. Yeah guys, so I've added the effects, and like I can say, I've prolonged the mashup, because if I had prolonged it when we were recording, it would have taken like an hour or so. So I'm back. So I believe we left it over here. Hopefully, if I've lost you, you'll just follow up. I'll zoom in every detail so that you can get a glimpse of what I usually do. So over here, I've added the effects. As you can see, there's a glass over here and the glass over here. So let me start talking from here as we keep on going forward. So over here, I've added the glasses and I've made a scratch over here. I'll zoom in. 32 boxes scratch, as you see. Yeah, nothing spectacular, just like that. Or you can tweak it. Yeah, up to you, it doesn't matter. So as you keep on going, yeah, so I'll mute the scratches. So I've looped this section on the reverb section on the reverb audio track, as you can see. So when I play it with the when there are scratches, this is how it will sound like. So I took this section where this guy say, "There I go." So it's not like closer, it's kind of far. So I brought it closer so that somebody can feel like there's something really happening, not just doing the next snare or the next kick. We are using the farthest snare or the farthest kick. So when I play it, this is how it will sound like. Yeah, and I've laid it on the this way, the express delay. Here it is, so that the flow of the song, I can continue it over here, because when I play it from here, it will be totally off. So I took it over here and play it a little on the wah-wah. Yeah, just like that. Then looped it at the bottom so that you can feel it fading away. Yeah, just like that. Then over here, I did some cut. Yeah, it's like this is the song. So I did slice these ones and lay them on the reverb, just like that. Yeah, so over here, I did some 32 boxes and 16 boxes scratch. Yeah, just like that. Yeah, just like that. So over here, I just used -1 to -7. Just Yeah, nothing spectacular. If you've watched the previous Scratch tutorials, I'm pretty sure you're familiar with what I'm talking about on this section. So what I've come to learn is that I'm using both the snares and the drum kicks. Yes, because when I'm trying to combine all of them to give it more life. So over here, I believe it's a snare. And the same over here, the snare. So don't worry about the scratches. You can do yours, you can copy mine and make them better. It depends with what kind of person you are when it comes to experimenting and learning more. Yeah, so as kept on going. So this song continues over here, I'm the man. So it took this section and laid it at the bottom and looped it. So over here, this is what I did. I made like 16 boxes. It took the 4 boxes, added a scratch and added another one at the bottom and pitched them, reversed these ones and pitched them just like that. Yeah, so when you play it, this is how it will sound like. Just like that. Yeah, I won't talk about anything over here. It's the usual one. So when I press play over here, I did make a scratch. And then in the middle, I added an express delay. So here we go. So as you've seen, I used this snare and scratched it over here. Yeah, just like that. As you've seen, this song is continuing. I haven't looped it starting from here. I've used the section that was to play to keep the flow going. And then reversed it, then laid this at the bottom and where the reverb is at. As you see, the reverb. So, and then did some slicing and cutting. Then over here it's a snare which is on a reverb. Then added my DJ drop. The king. And then over here I made a longer scratch. So to concerning the scratches on this section, we'll talk about them and talk about it as well on the scratch, hip hop scratch patterns. Yeah. So this is how it sounds like. The king. So without the track. Yeah, just like that. Just like that, and we wrap it up. So yeah, I just sliced and pushed it. So this section, this is this section. So I sliced it and pushed it over here. Yeah, just like that. So did the same thing. It took this one and laid it over here and made it -1 and -2. And that's it. So let me play it from the top. Then we wrap it up. The king. And that's how you usually do it. So for tutorial purposes, I would like you guys to experiment. You can search this song. It's called Okay Then by Lil Nico featuring DJ Khaled. Do your magic. Then we share the ideas. Maybe there's something you'll do that I don't know, or somebody else doesn't know. So when you share it, all of us will like learn something new. So before I wind it up, guys, I just want to say thank you for the support that you've been giving me here and there. I really appreciate it. I usually don't take it lightly. Yeah, me and GZD, we usually say thank you so much for the love. So if you want to catch our mixtapes, yeah, you can just jump on Hear This and type in Ground Zero DJs and you'll find us over there. And even Vimeo, there are couple, like we got like 3 videos in Vimeo. I'll leave the link in the description. So you can dive in and take and watch them. And I'm pretty sure you're gonna be inspired. So guys, for the guys who still want to purchase the 3D animations, as you can see, I still got them. Here they are. You just make your selection. You can select the $12 one, or even you can go extreme and select the $16 one. It depends with what you want. So here they are. Just jump to our Telegram channel, and for more information, you can just DM me on my IG, and I will take you through on how we can do business. So that's one way you can support the channel. And if you feel like donating, yeah, there's a on the description. There's a I've laid down some info on how you can donate. So we share the love so that we can keep on going. So here we go. So another thing, most of individuals usually find these 2 packs having password. So these are the effects that I sat down and selected them. Yeah, because they are great. So if you want to have the password, you have to purchase them. It's just $3. Yeah, so you know what you gotta do. So guys, I've been DJ Sub, and see you on the next one.